Nigel Farage with a tweet today, Patrick, saying the Sue Gray report tells me there is no accountability left in public life in this country, but also saying the PM will continue in office and the party will hit the rocks at the next election. Now, look, I accept the fact that Boris Johnson has been proved himself. He's got the track record of being a very skilled campaigner, a very successful track record when it comes to winning elections. But I have to say, on the current trajectory, I actually think we could be heading for a, I don't think Labour will get a majority, but a Labour alliance with the likes of the Lib Dems, with the likes of the Green Party, with the likes maybe of the SNP to get Keir Starmer into Downing Street. Not because Labour are marvellously, you know, performing strongly, but because certainly on my channel, and if you look at the polling, you can see it more widely, there are a lot of Brexiteers, there are a lot of people who voted Conservative for the first time at the last general election, who don't feel that when you talk about dealing our negotiations with the EU on the deal, on the protocol, when it comes to the Channel migration, illegal migration crisis, they don't feel that the government is doing enough. They get the sense, they get incredibly frustrated. There's a lot of words, what they might or intend to do, but very little happening. And so I actually think at the moment we could be heading for a sort of lefty, so-called progressive coalition government. What do you make of that?
Well, I mean, I don't often agree with Nigel, probably a couple of times a year. But I think it's over the top what he said. I think it's all still to play for in terms of the next general election. And I think Peter Bone raised some of the points you've raised there in the Commons Chamber, that what most sort of Tory inclined voters want is progress on cost of living, is progress on Brexit and the Northern Ireland protocol, and is progress on stopping the channel hopping by illegal migrants. And they are certainly beginning to notice this thing of the government talks a good game far too often across far too many fronts with almost no delivery following. So, you know, I think those are the sorts of issues, that's the agenda that will determine whether the Tories can stay in government. And we shouldn't forget that for four elections in a row, they've emerged as the biggest party, two of those elections with outright majorities. You know, it gets harder. It does get harder to keep getting re-elected. But let's note they'll start the next election with 150 approximately seats, more than the Labour Party has. Yes, there's the risk of this rainbow alliance of wackos to get Starmer in, and every little party will have its price. But equally, the vista of that is a really cogent weapon for the Conservatives to wield at the next general election, a bit like they wielded in 2015 when the spectre of Nicola Sturgeon bossing Ed Miliband about turned English voters against the Labour Party and delivered the Tories a majority. So again, I say it's too early to write off the Conservatives, to write off Boris Johnson. All is really still to play for, but the government needs to raise its game and start not just talking, but doing.